Did Matt Swift actually create this term? I'll give him credit for it.
Selective ignoring.
I like that.
It has nothing to do with like your spouse or anything like that. It's, you know, it's actually, I got one laugher and buzz. Everything's good at home, I hope. And so if I, you know, got shot in the chest, you know, which would be very unfortunate. Shot in the chest with a shotgun. Boz has a broken arm, and Nicole broke her nail. Okay, and she just got her nails done, so it's kind of a big deal. So we all go to the hospital. Hopefully, I get seen first, right? Like, that would be really cool. It'd be the proper execution of the triage concept. Just because I get seen first, they're not saying to Boz that your broken arm's not important. You know, it's by all means important and needs to get fixed, but when we look at the grand scheme of things, this person's gonna get our attention first. So all aspects of the movement are important, but just being realistic about the movement, you need to choose where you're gonna focus your attention and give it to the most important thing. If you're then happy with that, then move on to the second in the priority list and the third in the priority list. And that's only going to come with a game plan.
Just to kind of watch JP, and then we'll talk about what we're seeing, some ways to fix it. So go ahead and go down for me, Jay. Back up. Good, let's go two more down. Up. What do you guys think? I mean, it's not bad. You know what I mean? JP's got a good squat. What do you guys seeing? Anything?
He's kind of losing his lumbar curve at the end. A little soft at the bottom.
Okay, great. So we got some little bit of soft at the bottom, we're thinking. Anything else, guys?
Slightly on the toes.
Yeah, so let's kind of address these things, right? So if he is having a loss of lumbar curve, that would be the biggest thing. So let's address that.
We talked about the triage concept of prioritizing faults, and that can be in just an individual or in a group as well. You can kind of scan your class that you're teaching, and you know, within probably 5 or 10 reps of just watching everybody, see in general who are the individuals that pretty much get the movement, who are the ones that are kind of close, and they're gonna need a little bit of attention, but you think you can get them tuned up, and the ones that have no damn idea what's actually going on whatsoever.